How you doing, baby? You're right here. We're working on a, let's pan this in real quick, get you some good shots. We are working on a Whirlpool Duet. Let me get this on the Zoom phone. I'm pretty horrible at this. That'll be getting better, ladies and gentlemen. There it is. Whirlpool Duet. It's a electric car. And what we've got today is, we've had a broken valve issue. The dryer quit functioning, the control panel would come on. And I'll show you here. This button here, control will bring it on. Start button would hit the button, it would count the time down, but it wouldn't rotate. So I noticed back in here, there's actually a switch for the belt. So I gotta make sure that this pulley is in the correct location for the dryer to come on. So if the belt snaps, it will not work. Alrighty. Now, so what we're gonna do here is I've already got the new belt on. I was able to remove screws here and here at the corner, they're a quarter inch. I was able to sneak this forward after I removed all these screws. I'll show you the opposite reverse of how it goes back together, so just reverse this step. Now once you get this one and the other two inside, you can kind of manipulate this and lift the basket at the same time. Get the belt around and you'll want to slide it back and forth so it goes back. Make sure it's not caught on anything and don't go around the heating element. So once you get there, make sure the belt's not twisted like the belt in your car. You don't want it all bound up. And then try to remember location where the belt went. If it's broken, you can't really, so don't worry about that. There, maybe go online. I'm cleaning all this other stuff out, all the dirt, debris, whatnot. That way it's clean, won't catch fire. This stuff tends to stick to the elements and likes to catch on fire. Anyway, here we go now. Alright. Go ahead and put our two screws back in. We don't need four. Make sure everything's in place. Wheels, rollers. It might be good to leave these loose, actually, to get this lower section on real quick. Actually, restricts lots of airflow. So, I know when I work on cars, they have the same style blades inside the blowers for the AC and the HVAC case. It's pretty much the same stuff. I'll follow this, get back to you.